Hey guys, it's Clarice. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to be showing you how to remove dip powder nails without a drill. I think this will be really cool, so let's get right into it. So I did these Rossi dip powder nails a little while ago. You can check it out in this video here. But they have now since grown out and I'm ready to take them off. But instead of just soaking them off the normal way, like using aluminum foil and acetone, or even using a nail drill, we're going to be doing a very interesting soak off method that involves hot water. So I'm going to show you guys how I do it. So you're going to need a bowl of hot water. So you want a small to medium sized bowl, fill it up about halfway with water. And I'm going to microwave it here for about 2 minutes. And when it comes out, you basically want it to be very hot. And if you want, you can keep a container of water nearby to keep refilling it to keep it hot, because that is the key to make this work. Next, you're going to need acetone or nail polish remover. This one's running out, so I'm also going to be using this nail polish remover. And it does have a bunch of other things in it, but the first ingredient is acetone, so that will be fine. Then you're going to need a sandwich bag and a paper towel folded in half like this. So here are what my dip powder nails look like. So what you're going to want to do is open your bag up and pour in about 1/4 cup of acetone. I didn't really measure it, but you basically want there to be a good amount inside there. I'll put a little bit more. Now your hands will get very dried out by this. So what you can do is you can use a brush to kind of brush on cuticle oil on your hands to protect it. But another thing you can do is just take a little bit of the oil and just put some directly into the acetone, and that will help to not dry out your hands too much. Now you're going to take the paper towel and put it inside. Then I'm going to put my hand inside of the bag to the bottom. And what you basically want to be doing is just kind of scrunching around your fingers like this in the water. And then you're going to put your hand inside of the bowl of water. Now, if it does get hot, you can always take your hand out like this and put it back in when your hand is cooled off a little bit. Okay guys, so I've been going at it for about 6 minutes, and as you can see, so much of it has already come off. It just feels like there's just a little bit of residue left, so I'm just going to keep going for a little bit longer. That was just 6 minutes, guys. And one thing to note is the more layers of dip powder you use, the longer it'll take to come off. Here I'm using 3 layers. Okay, so now it's been 11 minutes in, and they basically are all clean. Guys, this is crazy in just 10 minutes. So here are my natural nails after wearing the dip powder for 4 weeks. They are doing pretty well, and they were able to grow out very nicely while I was wearing that dip powder, so that is great. And it only took 10, 11 minutes to soak off, probably even less if you only had 2 layers of dip powder. Now you can go apply base coat of choice and go on to do a new manicure. But I'm going to do right now a few basic nail care steps because I haven't been able to do anything for them very much with the dip powder on. First, I'm going to grab my glass nail file. And they did grow out quite a bit during this time. The dip powder was honestly really nice. I mean, I just don't have to worry about one hand of my nails very much. Like, I do need to keep one hand open for filming tutorials. But it was honestly very nice not having to worry about the nails. Next, I'm going to apply cuticle remover to all my nails, and this will soften up and dissolve the cuticle, any dead skin, so that I can easily scrape it off. I'm also happy to see that there is basically no staining from after that dip powder. Of course, it wasn't a very dark color. If you guys are interested in the dip powder I used, I will have a link below for you to check it out from Rossi Nails. And I'm going to go wash my hands of that gel there. Then I'm going to apply some cuticle oil to make my nails happy again. Alright guys, so as you can see, that was very easy. I didn't have to do any chipping or peeling. You don't want to do that anyways. I hope this was helpful. If you've ever heard of this hack or have used it before, you can comment below your experience. And it might be hard for you to tell, but this is a bull. But, and... be reviewing the She Modern reusable flexible reusable for my next video, I did win some SheModern reusable stencil. I did get the diamond shape pattern one. And I've never used this before, so I'm going to be trying this out in my next video, so that'll be really fun. So if you're not already, I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel and click the bell. I post on Wednesdays and Saturdays. Remember that a smile is the prettiest thing you can wear. So I hope to see you in my next video. Thank you again so much for hanging out with me. I hope this was helpful, and have a magical day.